Hello everyone, I am Huawei Instructor Lee Shinuan. In the last class, we talked about how to configure WLAN services using the command line. In this class, we will explain how to configure the same service using the web method, in order to make it more convenient for customers to use Huawei's devices. Our AC and AP can also be configured through the web interface. It's somewhat similar to the routers we used before. In this class, I will explain to you how to configure settings on the web interface. So, in this class, we have two parts. First, the first part is the configuration process. Let me briefly explain this process to everyone, because the process is exactly the same as the process we discussed in the previous class. In the second half of this class, I will explain the interface of web configuration to everyone. What are the functions of each button like? First, let's talk about web network management. In fact, configuring the web network management is very simple. Very similar to the routers we use at home. In this topology map that we are looking at, our AC device is connected to the PC device through a network. Why is there an IP network in the middle? In other words, our PC does not necessarily have to be directly connected to the AC. As long as the PC can access the AC, in other words, between PC and AC, as long as they are three-layer reachable, then we can configure our business through the web. So here, there are four tasks that we need to complete in advance. First, the device access port has been configured with an IP address. In other words, we definitely need an IP address on our AC, because our PC needs to access the AC, so the AC needs an IP address. Secondly, the PC terminal must be interoperable with our devices. That's what I just explained, the interconnection at the third layer. The third point, of course, is the HTTP and HTTPS services. In our demonstration, we are using the HTTPS service. Actually, generally speaking, this service is supported on our PCs. Finally, we need browsing software on our PC. That is to say, any browser, whether IE or Chrome, can be used. Now let's take a look at the interface of our web. The interface of this web is actually very similar to the interface of wireless routers that we often see. Drawing a red box around the area, these are some basic commands. We can save, we see in our save, that there is auto-save, its current feature is timed saving. How long does it take before it automatically saves? Here we can also change our language. You can also change the mode. Then there are different users. Different permissions can be granted to different users. So, this interface is one of the more commonly used interfaces. Hello everyone, I am Huawei Instructor Lee Shinuan. In the last class, we talked about how to configure WLAN services using the command line. In this class, we will explain how to configure the same service using the web method, in order to make it more convenient for customers to use Huawei's devices. Our AC and AP can also be configured through the web interface. It's somewhat similar to the routers we used before. In this class, I will explain to you how to configure settings on the web interface. So, in this class, we have two parts. First, the first part is the configuration process. Let me briefly explain this process to everyone, because the process is exactly the same as the process we discussed in the previous class. In the second half of this class, I will explain the interface of web configuration to everyone. What are the functions of each button like? First, let's talk about web network management. In fact, configuring the web network management is very simple. Very similar to the routers we use at home. In this topology map that we are looking at, our AC device is connected to the PC device through a network. Why is there an IP network in the middle? In other words, our PC does not necessarily have to be directly connected to the AC. As long as the PC can access the AC, in other words, between PC and AC, as long as they are three-layer reachable, then we can configure our business through the web. So here, there are four tasks that we need to complete in advance. First, the device access port has been configured with an IP address. In other words, we definitely need an IP address on our AC, because our PC needs to access the AC, so the AC needs an IP address. Secondly, the PC terminal must be interoperable with our devices. That's what I just explained, the interconnection at the third layer. The third point, of course, is the HTTP and HTTPS services. In our demonstration, we are using the HTTPS service. Actually, generally speaking, this service is supported on our PCs. Finally, we need browsing software on our PC. That is to say, any browser, whether IE or Chrome, can be used. Now let's take a look at the interface of our web. The interface of this web is actually very similar to the interface of wireless routers that we often see. Drawing a red box around the area, these are some basic commands. We can save, we see in our save, that there is auto save, its current feature is timed saving. How long does it take before it automatically saves? Here we can also change our language. You can also change the mode. Then there are different users. Different permissions can be granted to different users. So, this interface is one of the more commonly used interfaces.